This is going to be a JDBC tutorial covering embedded Derby database. So I'm going to start by creating a Java application, and then I'm going to use JDBC for creating an embedded Derby database, and then creating a table in that database, and then inserting records into that table, and finally selecting and displaying all records in that table. I'll start by creating a Java project. And I'm going to call it Embedded Derby Project 01. And here I'm going to create a Java class that I'm going to call createDB, and the package is going to be com.za.tutorial, and it's going to have a main method. And I'll also create another class that I'm going to call QueryDB, and it's also going to have a main method. Next, I'm going to go to my Derby project, and I'm going to create a folder. I'm going to call it lib. And going to my downloaded Derby, downloaded and unzipped Derby core plugin, I'm going to pick up this jar file, the Derby jar file, and drop it here in the library. And then I'm gonna go to properties, and add jar, and I'm gonna go ahead and add this Derby jar. Now the first thing I'm gonna need is a driver. So I'm going to use org.apache.derby.jdbc.embedded driver. And I'm going to be doing class.forName on this driver. And to pick up a connection, I'm going to use this JDBC URL, so JDBC and Derby, and the database name, I'm going to call it ZADB, and create is true. And I'll do get connection on this JDBC URL using the driver manager, so the static method get connection on the driver manager. And next, I'm going to use this connection instance in order to create a table, the channels table. So I'm going to do connection.create statement, which is going to give me back a statement, and then call execute on that statement. And so the SQL is going to be create table. The table name is going to be channels, and the fields are channel and topic and video clip. And after creating this table, I'm gonna insert tuples into this, into that table. And the way I'm gonna do that is using connection dot create statement dot execute, and I'm gonna do an insert into channels, and the values are gonna be, so this is the first tuple, OODP, creational and singleton. This is the second tuple, and this is the third tuple. And then I'm just gonna print out a statement saying that a table was created and the records were successfully inserted. And actually I can test this right now, so let me do that. I'm gonna run the create db. Here we go, so channels table created and records successfully inserted. So let's see if this database was created, the ZADB. So if I do a refresh here, here we go. So this is the database that was created, the embedded Derby database. Okay, so next I'm gonna do the query DB in order to query this table in the ZADB database and see if I return those values that I inserted here. So here first I'm gonna pick up a connection, and in order to do that I'm gonna be using this JDBC URL from create DB. So create db.jdbc URL. And using this connection instance, I'm gonna create a statement. And the SQL that I'm gonna be executing is a select statement for all tuples in the channels table. So I'm gonna use the statement instance in order to call execute query on it and execute this query here, which is gonna give me back a result set. And I can use that result set in order to pick up a result set metadata. And use that result set metadata in order to figure out the number of columns that I have. So the column count. And I'm gonna use this column count in order to print out the columns that I have. So I'm gonna do a for statement and printing out system out dot format result dot set metadata result set metadata dot get column names. And so the format, what this is gonna give me is, I'm gonna format it so that all the columns that I get back are gonna be 20 character size. And next I'm gonna do a while loop in order to print out the tuples. So I'm gonna have a for statement inside this while loop in order to print out all the columns, and they're all gonna be 20 character sizes. And so I'm gonna use result set dot get string, and passing in the column. So starting from one to smaller or equal to column count. And I'm gonna put a system out dot print line here. And lastly, I'm gonna go ahead and close the statement and the connection. So let me do a save all and go ahead and run this and see if it's gonna give me back those three tuples that I inserted here. Here we go. So I have a channel and the topic and the video clip, and the tuples are so OODP, creational and singleton, and then factory method, and then abstract factory.
Thank you.